Alright, hey don't know guys, welcome back to another video. This video I would say is a very much you guys have been asking for this video. You don't know, it's one of the most anticipated videos that I will be making at this point. But yeah, so this video is how I lost 60 pounds and changed my life completely. You know? But yeah, let's just get right into it. So about 2 years ago, 2.5 or 3 years ago, I think, I was going to school. I was doing CSEC at the time, right? So, of course, you know, during CSEC, you have extra class and this and that and, you know, one bag of thing. So, I went to a math class after school, but it was up UE, you see me? So, normally what I would do is, as a school done at 3 o'clock, I just go straight up to UE. But I'd be hungry, you see me? Because I haven't eaten from, lunchtime was like way, way early and school finished at 3. So, normally I would probably stop at Sovereign or so. So, you don't know, said, when I go Sovereign, you know, me I go, I go KFC or and get a big deal, or me I go Yao and me I get fried chicken, the curry, gravy, the fried rice, the barbecue, chicken, this, that, everything, isn't it? KFC, you don't know, big deal, barbecue original, barbecue thing at all, you don't know, you can't left out that. But yeah, so that's how me I go on, man, you know. And so yeah, reach up to you, box off the KFC real quick, and then yeah, when class done again, we stop again and get more food before me go home. So it was really just a cycle of that. It was a continuous cycle. But of course, you don't know, my mom and I both realized that you could have seen weight was going to, it was being put on. So we did come up with the idea and say, alright, when CSEC is done, right, there was a gym that was right across from my school. So I was like, yo, I should just probably start a gym when, you know, I have nothing to do this summer, isn't it? So said, so done. That same summer, yeah, went straight across the road, went over to the gym. Big up Chris, you don't know. That summer, it don't work. Every day at the gym, outside in the hot sun, push, sled, whole heap of things. Push big heavy tire, you know, the rope something, yeah, whole heap of cardio, and yeah, it was a lot every single day, you don't know. And throughout that whole process, I think at the end of it, it was about 2 months, I lost about 39 or 40 pounds, yeah. And I'm not gonna lie, when I was at 246 pounds in the year, right, I did say that I was just going to lose like 40 pounds or so, and I should be able to maintain the weight at 200, you know, I should be able to look, you know, somewhat normal at 200. That was not the case. When I got to 200, it still never looked right. That was just that. It did not look right, you know. To me, based on how, since I was on that journey already, it just never looked like where I wanted to be. So I said, let me continue. So throughout this whole school year, of course, trying to go to the gym after school didn't work out. I'd go to school in the morning, they don't know me, I try to reach school early, you know. And so I would buy curry chicken and fried dumpling, you know, you see me, for breakfast. I don't know how. That wasn't even near healthy. I don't know. As I said, I was eating for flavor back then, like mostly for taste and not for quality and for fuel, you know, which I should have been doing. But as I said, it's a learning process. But yes, so you don't know, the curry chicken and the fried dumpling and the orange juice, and yeah, it was really, yeah, those days, man. Don't miss it though. But yeah, so yeah, and for lunch, you don't know, we're gonna have the 2-piece and the fries, and or we're gonna get the rice and peas and the fried chicken and the curry gravy. And you don't know, say we clean out box, and like when we done with the food box, you know, the box empty, you know, like it, you can put back, you like a brand new box you get, you see, the box never used yet. Is it me? So yeah, so I was eating, I don't know what I was doing, is it me? So it's like a constant process of going to the gym, eating back. So at the end of the day, no progress was really made. I think I only, yeah. So continuing the story now, so I was about 200 pounds, about that, just under that, you know. And then yeah, throughout the whole school year, I started badminton, and not gonna lie, that I was very pretty active in that. You know, I was seeing some results in that. I was starting to lose more weight again, because again, I was more active, so I was burning more calories in addition to the gym. So that was really beneficial. But then after a while, you know, school give holiday and things. So it was just a really on and off process after that. But the real bulk of the work was that first summer as well. But now I go to the gym now. But yeah, so during the weight loss process, while I was during that summer when I was doing the whole working out thing and at the gym, what I was eating, it was I don't know, I wasn't eating as how I should have been. I wouldn't say I was eating properly either. but I was eating less. I was just eating less of everything, you know. I would even say I was starving myself sometimes, which I don't recommend, you know. Don't recommend that, because of course it does the complete opposite. Of course, when your body goes in survival mode, you tend to hold on to fat and reserve whatever you have in your body left instead of getting rid of it. So do not skip meals and do not, you know, starve yourself. That's one thing. But yeah, I was eating, I was drinking protein shakes, and I think I had, let's say for breakfast, I had 3 boiled eggs. But yeah, man, throughout the whole process during the summer, I think I was kind of starving myself. Still, I was eating every now and then, but it wasn't like anything, you know. It was no strict diet plan or whatever. I was just freestyling it and just eating less, because, you know, that's what I thought was right. I did get results. The results I got worse, they were good, I will say they were good for what I did, but they were not where I wanted to be as yet. Still not at where I want to be as yet, but we're getting there, you know. I must say it's been a work in progress from 2 years ago then and till now. Still in the gym, you don't know. At some point in time, I'll show you progress, as in now pictures, you know. But through the whole of this, I'll be putting the before pictures and the after pictures. And so to recap the video, or to sum up most of what I've said. So the first thing I did was make a decision, you know. You have to come to decision and start. You have to make a decision at first. You can't just say you're going to go into it, isn't it? So my decision was that at the end of that C-sec period, at the end of that period, I would have started the gym for that summer and, you know, started to work on myself. That was the decision made. Next thing, so starting the gym was only the first decision. Actually following through and going to the gym and signing up was another. There was a whole lot of tasks to do that, you don't know. But we did it. The three is just you actually maintaining this process of, you know, that you have to get up every day and know, say, you cannot eat what you want or eat for flavor or eat for taste, or, you know, it's about eating for quality, you see me? Or eating, let's say, or just the portion size, you know, eating less, eating consciously. That is it, eating consciously. How bad do you want it? How bad do you want it? I know I wanted it bad. But yeah, I remember when I was big, and I remember people used to tell me, say, yo, him now get big enough. Him born too big. Him a big bone. Alright, let me just say this, right? Anybody who said I'm a big bone, a rubbish. Rubbish, rubbish, rubbish. I used to agree with that and say, yeah man, me a big bone, man, and rubbish, rubbish. Don't stop telling yourself that foolishness. That doesn't exist, okay? But yeah. People used to always say, oh, him born for big, him can't lose weight, man. Nah, man, that in him jeans. Jeans wear. Let me just tell you something right here, you know. You write your reality. You make your reality what it is, you know. Don't listen to nobody who tell you, say, yo, you know, you can't do that, or is it me? Because it is possible. Like, how can you make somebody tell you that, and you don't even figure it out for yourself? Like, that don't make sense, is it me? You know, when you have those people who are saying the negative things and the negativity around, you just try to move away from the negativity. But you see me? Put yourself in a different mind space, you know. You know what you're after. You know what your goal is. It's just about getting to the goal itself, you know. How will you get there is solely up to you. That's literally the mentality you have to have, isn't it? Alright, so I'm not sure in which order I posted them or which order I'm going to post it, but I will be posting a video with 20 tips, or just tips and tricks overall, about the whole weight loss process and what you need to do and what you shouldn't do. And, you know, tips that will just help. I know people out there who want these tips, and I know people who need the tips, because personally, when I was in the weight loss journey, I needed the tips. Like, I used to go on YouTube and just watch countless videos, like countless transformation videos, countless videos with tips. So, you know, at the end of the day, just do you. Busy me. But yeah, more videos coming soon. Big up on yourself. If you're seeing this right now and you know that you wanted to start the journey, this is your sign. This is your sign to start the journey. You know, this is the first step. This is me telling you. So please go ahead and start the journey. You don't know. Take it before pictures. Do your check-in. Do your weigh-ins. Keep track. Track your things. You don't know. Yeah. So you don't know. If you guys like the story time and like the video, you don't know. Like the video. Share the video. Comment. Don't forget to subscribe as well. You don't know. Share the video with somebody too. You don't know. Big up on yourself, you know. I'm out.